गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ योर मैथ्स वन ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन। आई होप एवरीथिंग इज़ फाइन एट योर एंड एंड यू ऑल आर फीलिंग क्वाइट रिलैक्स आफ्टर योर फर्स्ट यूनिट टेस्ट। नाउ लेट अस कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम वेयर वी लेफ्ट। वी स्टार्टेड विद द सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज रियल नंबर्स। टूडे आई विल बी टीचिंग यू फर्दर इन दिस चैप्टर फ्यू इम्पॉर्टेंट सम्स। ओके, बट बिफोर वी डू दैट, लेट अस क्विकली रिकैप वॉट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर। ओके, now here I have written just three basic points. As first is a definition of rational number. Now how to define a rational number? Rational number is a number that can be expressed in p upon q form, where q is not equal to 0. Yes, in easy way how we will understand this? Rational numbers are fractions in which the denominator should not be equal to 0. Now look at these examples which I have given you: 10 upon 2, 30 upon 5, etc. Now if you look at this, it can be further reduced. 10 upon 2 can be written as 5 upon 1. Yes or no? Is it a rational number? Yes, because even though it is 5 upon 1, I just want the denominator not equal to 0. It is 1, it is not equal to 0. So 10 upon 2 is very well a rational number. Same way 30 upon 5 is also a rational number. Okay, so this we have learned about rational number. Then we have learned irrational number. Now how to define irrational number? Easiest way is, the numbers which are not rational are called irrational numbers. Or if the decimal form of a number is non-recurring and non-terminating, then those numbers are called as irrational numbers. I hope you remembered all this, that if I give you an example of 22 upon 7, yes, you keep on dividing it, non-recurring, division will not come to an end, non-terminating. Yes, non-terminating means division will not come to an end, and non-recurring means quotient will not repeat itself. Every now and then you are going to get different remainder. Okay, remainder will not repeat itself. This is the meaning of non-recurring and non-terminating. Two examples I have given you here, root 2 and root 3. Yes, if you divide it by division method, which you have learned in 8th standard, root 2. Yes, you will see that remainder is not coming to an end, remainder is not coming to zero, and even the division is not coming to an end. You will keep on dividing, you will get different quotient every now and then. Okay, so such numbers are nothing but irrational numbers. Now in this session, what we are going to learn? In this session, we are going to learn how to represent irrational numbers on a number line. That too, this is our textbook exercise question, how to represent root 5 and root 10 on a number line. This is what I will be teaching you in this session. I have also included here root 2. Yes, why? Because this you have already learned in 8th standard. I hope you recollect that. This is the way you used to draw root 2 on a number line. Now this is not a number line, I have just shown a part of it. This is a way we used to get one unit distance here, one unit distance here. Then that hypotenuse is nothing but root 2, and we used to get an arc over here on this side on the number line. This you have already learned. Then what we are going to learn now? We are going to learn this, how to represent root 5 on a number line. I will be teaching you this, as well as how to represent root 10 on a number line. Okay, now I hope you have understood till now that you require a geometry box and a pen and a pencil and a paper. Please get all the things and be ready for the construction. As and when I am telling you, you will draw along with me so that the concept is clear to you. Okay, let us continue with the construction. Okay, now let us have a look at this video in order to understand the construction, and you also do along with me, right? Okay, see this. What we are going to do is, we are going to do construction of root 5 and root 10 on a number line. So first thing that you need to do is draw a number line. With the help of a scale, we draw a number line. Now number line, I hope you know what it is. Since it is a line, show arrows on both the sides and write number on it, starting with 0 at the center. Now since we are doing construction, one unit distance should be taken as 3 cm. Now randomly you don't mark 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2 on the number line. Take 3 cm as a unit distance and write 1, 2, 3 on this number line. Similarly, to the left hand side, same distance, 1 centimeter, 1 unit distance as 3 centimeter. Okay, and there also you write -1, -2. So this is 1 unit distance, that is 3 centimeter. So I am writing 1, 2, 3 to the right side. Same way, 3 centimeter I'll take and write -1 and -2. It should be 3 centimeter. This is what I need to write as a scale on the right hand side. What should be the scale? Scale is 1 unit distance is equal to 3 centimeter. Now, no hard and fast rule. You can also take it as 2 centimeter, but provided it should be visible enough. So I have taken it as 3 centimeter. Even it can be taken as 2 centimeter, no problem. Okay. I have taken 3 so that we can construct it properly. Now root 2 you have already learned. I am going to show you today root 5. For root 5 what we should do? We are going to draw perpendicular on 2. Okay? So on 2 with the help of a protractor draw a perpendicular. That is 90 degree. Okay? So at 2 we are drawing 90 degree. Represent that 90 degree. First draw an arrow and draw a 90 degree mark at 2. Okay, after this in your compass take 1 unit distance. How much was that? 3 centimeter. Yes, 1 unit distance was how much? 3 centimeter. So that you are going to take in your compass. Take, see this 3 centimeter 3 centimeter. Okay, keep it at 2 and draw an arc on the arm that you have drawn just now. How much it is? 3 centimeter, that is 1 unit distance. Join this to the origin, that is 0. Yes, join this to 0. This is a hypotenuse. Now as you can see, I am going to take this hypotenuse in my compass. Yes, hypotenuse, because this is a right angle triangle. So I am going to take the distance of the hypotenuse in the compass. O as a center, that is 0 as a center. Draw an arc cutting the number line. This point is nothing but root 5. I hope you have understood the basic steps. Mark this triangle as triangle B at the vertex A and O. Okay, which triangle? Now I am justifying myself why this is root 5. So I'll write in triangle ABO. As you can see, this is a right angle triangle. So I'm going to use Pythagoras theorem. Yes or no? Where B is 90 degree. So it will be OA square is equal to AB square plus OB square. I hope you remember the Pythagoras theorem, side 1 square plus side 2 square. So OA square is equal to AB square plus OB square. How much is OB? As you can see, it is 2 unit distance. 1 unit plus 2, 1 plus 1, that is 2. So that is AB square is 1, 1 square plus OB is 2, so 2 square. So we get 1 plus 4, OA square as 5. Now take square root on both sides. You may get OA as root 5. This is the reason why I am telling you that this root OA which I am taking in my compass, OA only is the distance which I have taken in my compass. Yes, and that arc is drawn. Since OA is root 5, hence this point which is shown on the number line automatically becomes root 5. Okay, now let us see how to draw root 10. For root 10, we are going to draw exactly the same way, 90 degree at 3. Yes, a perpendicular at 3. Steps are exactly same. The only difference is instead of 2, I am going to draw the perpendicular at 3 now. So indicate that 90 degree mark, right? Now, 1 unit distance as we have taken for root 5, same way. Distance was how much? 3 centimeter. Okay, take 1 unit distance, that is 3 centimeter, and now keep the compass at the point 3 as we have done for root 5. Same way for root 10, keep it at 3 and draw an arc cutting the arm. Yes, join this to 0 as we have done for root 5. Same way we are doing it here, we are joining this to 0. Now this is again the hypotenuse of this right angle triangle. Take that distance, the hypotenuse in your compass, the hypotenuse distance in your compass, 0 as the origin or the point where you need to keep your pointer, and draw an arc cutting the number line. wherever it intersects, that is nothing but root 10. I hope you are understanding it. It is exactly same as root 5. This distance in your compass, the hypotenuse, keep it at 0 and cut the number line. Wherever it intersects, that is nothing but root 10. Now name this triangle O, C and D. Okay, now this is also a right angle triangle, as you can see, with D as 90 degree. So in this also let us use Pythagoras theorem and justify ourselves. Okay, so right in triangle, which triangle I have to consider? Yes, I have told you which right angle triangle, O C D O or D O D C, any way you can write, where D is equal to 90 degree. Now hypotenuse square is one side square plus other side square, so we will get OC square is equal to CD square plus OD square, right? Now CD is 1 unit, see OD is how much, 1, 2 and 3, 3 unit distance, I hope you are understanding it. So CD will be written as 1 square and OD will be written as 3 square. So 1 square is 1 and 3 square is 9. So 1 plus 9 is nothing but 10. So OC square is equal to 10 and OC will be root 10, taking the square root. I hope you have understood the justification for root 5 and root 10. This is a way you need to draw it. Okay? I hope the steps are clear. Just quickly revise it. How we have done? First draw a number line. Yes? On the number line, mark the numbers as 1, 2, 3, 4 by taking 1 unit distance as 3 cm. You can even take 2 cm, no problem. Mark the numbers 1, 2, 3 to the right side of 0 and minus 1, minus 2 to the left side. Now, in order to draw root 5, what I have told you, on 2 you will draw a perpendicular, correct? And then 1 unit distance, that is 3 cm, you are going to draw an arc. Join it to the origin, that is 0. Take that OA as a distance in your compass, keeping the compass, the pointer at O. Cut the number line wherever it intersects, keeping the distance, how much distance you have to take? OA. Wherever it intersects the number line, that is nothing but root 5. And I have explained you the justification also by taking the right angle triangle ABO. Use Pythagoras theorem, you will justify yourself. Okay? Same way for root 10, what I have asked you, instead of drawing perpendicular on 2, now I will be drawing perpendicular on 3. Right? Perpendicular is drawn exactly same way. Cut the arm in by the arc of 1 unit distance. How much? 3 cm. Take this OC in your compass, the distance OC in your compass. Cut the number line wherever it intersects, that is nothing but root 10. Okay? Now, if you find difficulty in understanding it, you can pause the video and draw it as I have drawn and try to understand the justification also. If such questions are asked, it can be asked with justification. Root 5, how to justify, I have explained you. Even root 10, how to justify, that also we have done. So, I hope this method is understood. This is nothing but representation of irrational numbers on a number line. Okay? I hope now these two constructions are clear to you. So, we end this session here. Remaining, I am going to continue in the next session. Thank you.